Hello everyone, this is Thomas, and thank you for tuning in to episode 37 of our Starbase Weekly Update. Now let's dig in. Starting off this week, Ship 24, mounted onto Test Stand B, underwent some flap testing as its afts were observed opening and closing. On Sunday morning, some new equipment was lifted and installed onto the ship quick disconnect arm on the orbital launch tower. That afternoon, back over at Test Stand B, crews continue to work on installing scaffolding around Ship 24. It remains to be seen what the scaffolding will be fully utilized for, but so far, three rows of tiles have been removed off the ship's aft section. Monday morning, three center raptors with thrust vector control hardware were moved into high bay ahead of their integration with Ship 25. A few hours later, with the road closed, employees at the build site began gathering along Highway 4, indicating an imminent static fire. The new FireX suppression system on the orbital launch mount started spraying water and gaseous nitrogen. Then a fire once again roared from Booster 7. Thanks to a tweet from Elon, we know that this was a 14-engine static fire, making it the most powerful static fire in the history of the Starship program, easily beating out the previous record set during the Booster 7's last static fire of 7 Raptors for 7 seconds. Later, back at the build site, 3 vacuum Raptors were moved into high bay, completing the set of 6 engines for Ship 25. And just after midnight Tuesday morning, Bob returned to port with both Fahrenheits from the Galaxy 31 and 32 mission. Later that morning, Bob's crane lifted both Fahrenheits off the vessel and placed them on the dock. Meanwhile, Doug, SpaceX's other fairing recovery vessel, left port for some sea trials just a short distance offshore. On a very rainy Wednesday back at Starbase, a new test tank was rolled out of Mega Bay and into Mid Bay. Thursday afternoon, a tarp was hung between two of the legs on the orbital launch mount, possibly as a windbreak for welding operations on top of the Raptor maintenance platform. Meanwhile, a new pump motor for the liquid oxygen side of the orbital tank farm was delivered to the launch site. Eventually, the pump was offloaded from the truck and placed next to the fence near the horizontal methane tanks. Back at Port Canaveral, Doug was once again spotted headed out to sea, this time in preparation for recovering the fairings from the ULSAT 10B launch. To wrap up this week, after a few small issues were resolved, the long-awaited Artemis 1 mission finally launched at 1:47 Wednesday morning from Launch Complex 39B. This inaugural flight of NASA's Space Launch System made history as the most powerful rocket to ever reach orbit. The four RS-25D engines repurposed from the Space Shuttle program, along with the two 5-segmented solid rocket side boosters, turned night into day as they lofted the Orion space capsule into orbit and on its way to the moon. And there we have it, another weekly update of Starbase Texas and Cape Canaveral, Florida, brought to you by LabPadre. Thanks again for watching, and see you again next week.